Everybody, Dave here from Band of Badgers, and this is our second video for Epic Encounters Local Legends. If you want to see more, go check it out here. There you go, there's the playlist, and you'll find it on there somewhere, which is the main box. This is, we've got two items left, separate videos again. This is the GM screen. We'll take that away, come back to that again later. But this box is huge. This is the All-In Pledge. Epic Encounters Local Legends from Steamforge Games. Now, I was an all-in backer. I've paid for all this because I absolutely love Epic Encounters in any shape and form, and this was an extension to that. So it's very shiny, so I'm going to unwrap it and then we can get into it a little bit quicker. So let's take this off to start with. Got my trusty scissors so we can dig in. It arrived today. And today is the 10th of April, 2024. And Local Legends is a, oops, sorry about that. Local Legends is available now from steamforge.com directly. The main box is priced at £40. But this, I'm not sure what, you're only gonna get this. This is a Kickstarter exclusive, I'm assuming, or various bundles that you can get on the Steamforge website. But I'm hoping that this is gonna be the minis and the little extra box sets. But look at the box. This is the back of the box. I mean, this is absolutely gorgeous. So we've seen a lot of these character cards in the main core box. You've got the NPC, the inn, the encounters, the pubs themselves. There's a book about those. All the maps, the pubs, the illustrations of the pubs. It's like this. This is the outside. You flip it over and you get like an illustration. Not a battle map, but an illustration of that. Now, along with these, when you go into the pubs, you play, meet these people, you play the games. There are local legends. There are rumors about specific encounters. And those encounters, I'm assuming you can hear this box. There's a lot in this box. And it's quite weighty. It's easily heavier than the first box. So that's the lid is off now. And we have a pack of maps, by the looks of things. Here we go. Each encounter, so I'll be interested to see how big those are. And we have played a lot of the normal Epic Encounters on our show. We've done interviews, we've done miniature painting, we've played the games, we've done all kinds of things. Oh wow, and it's some Bard Song. I love Bard Song. Right now, can you hear that? That was cracking. This is the Encounters book, lovely looking book. This is. Here we go. I'm just going to, how many pages is this? So 100 pages, spot on. And these are filled with, like we would have seen in normal Epic Encounters, these are encounters with various monsters of all different types from the various pubs and the various rumors that you can find. This is an A5 kind of booklet, just like the normal booklets you get in Epic Encounters. And again, it's, if you looked at the first video, it's broken down, as you can see, the bold text there, into each of the 10 pubs, the 10 locations, the inns that your players may, not necessarily, well, they can start their adventure there, but, you know, they might go to a town, find a pub and join in. And you can see, look, here's the map we've got there. We've seen these in Epic Encounters. You'll be familiar. There you go. So you can see all those goody bits. Actually exciting, isn't it? Oh. Oop. There we go. So we'll have a look at those in a sec. I'll just get this out first. So this is going to be your book for everything in there for each adventure. Absolutely. And each of the pubs. It's really kind of breakdown of that encounter itself. And you can also see in here that underneath the book, look, there is a ton of miniatures. Can't see it because of reflection. But I'll get into it in a sec. Now, I was also a full backer for Bard Song from Steamforge Games. And I believe that some of the stuff that's in here, you can incorporate into your Bard Song game. So I'm hoping that that is true. Don't know how. This is one of the things I'm mainly looking forward to, is putting this into... Oh, I see. It's showing you how you can break up the map for Bard Song. Aha. Lovely. That'd be cool. So it is Epic Encounters based in the Bardsung universe. Or similar, something similar like that. Bardsung is a D&D 5e kind of inspired board game where you put it on and you adventure these. There is a story to it and you follow the adventure. It is a beautiful, and tons of minis. An absolutely beautiful game. Comes in a giant box. If you're familiar with games like Gloomhaven, it's that kind of size box. It's huge. But I'm going to enjoy reading. If there's anything you want to kind of look at, just press pause and try and read it. It won't. But what I'll do is I put some photos up on our... I mean, look, you get to fight that. Oh, and there's a mini, I believe, of that thing in here. There you go, look. There's a pub on a boat. Or shaped like a boat. No, well, yeah, kind of. A salt and kraken. You're going to fight a kraken? Maybe. I don't know. But yeah, I like that. I love... Look at that. Good expansion. We've got another big bag, which I think is going to be for the maps. It is, because you're going to peel it out of here. You want to keep them nice. And they've actually provided you another bag to put them in. Cool. Let's have a quick look at the maps, actually, because that intrigued me. I think they've given us two layouts, if I'm not mistaken. So is that a battle map and a Bardsung map? What a great idea. Right, let's get rid of that. That's never coming back. Let's get rid of the scissors. Keep that bag. But let's have a look. So you've got a whole range of maps going on. But let's have a look at this. Lovelies. Great quality. It doesn't even feel like paper. It's kind of got that laminate feel to it. So this is A2. In size, or slightly bigger than A1, but that's a ghost ship. That's amazing. You could use that anywhere. Once you bought it, you can do what you like with it. But yeah, look, that's a ghost ship. I love that. I'm about to use that in one of my salt marsh adventures. And okay, so this side is also a battle map. So these are going to be for the story, but I'm sure I saw here. Now look, is this a Bardsung map? Ooh, let's have a look. So the camera isn't big enough to get these things in. It is. Oh, really nice. Interesting. Flip it over. And we have another one. Sorry, I just hit the camera. Looks like some tents have been attacked there. Can't quite tell. But this is nice. Okay, so you could use the Bardsung rules to play another map. Oh, all right, now I'm interested. Oh, now I've got two games for the price of one. I wasn't expecting that. That's great. That's cool. Right, let's get this out of the way. Let's have a look at the minis. This is the important thing. Now we do have a miniature painting show called The Great British Brush Off, where we are joined by pro painters from all around the world to paint up some goodies. And then you get to judge them. But if you fancy painting with us and you've never painted, get in touch. Come and join us. So I'm just going to flick through. Now those are the boulders. We know those are for giants, but look. Are those ghosts or ghouls? Oh, those are from... Yeah, this is from the ghost ship, look. You see that? He's actually got... Let's try and zoom in a little bit here. Look at that. That is so cool. And kind of creepy at the same time. Ghost blades. These are the fire dudes, look. See how cute that is? Sorry, something out of a Pixar film. That is a guy trapped underneath a dead horse. That's like a not a mini, but it's like a, it is a mini, but it's a place. It's on a base already, look. Look at this one. Right, so we got those. What else we got? We got this. Who's that? Is that kind of wizard dude? He's a giant size. I don't think he's a wizard, but he's wearing robes. Not sure what that is. He's a hag. She's scary. Got these ones. They got these hands. Look at these arms coming out. Got these giant bats. Those are looking awesome. Got a couple of trees. Not sure what the trees are there for, but I like trees. Nothing against trees. So that's the batch of normal sized minis, if you like. So let's put that on there. Then on the other side, now we have this. You can see, so how is this going to come out? It's going to be noisy. Here we go. Right. That is probably not going to go. Going to start. Let's get this top off. There we go. Ooh, look at these. So these are some. Look at that. Absolutely good. I mean, how big is this? It's not like massively big, but look at that. That's nice. Like that. We've got a ogre. Another ogre. I have a lot of ogres at the moment. I think he's got a. It reminds me of the Frost Giant Epic Encounter. He had loads of blades stuck in his legs, which, why not? It's cool. That's giant. That going back in? Yep, I think so. Oh, there we go. There's a lovely griffin there. Look, it's gonna be beautiful to paint. Loads of detail. Loads of detail on the wings, feathering. So we might have to do a Great British Brush Off, I think. We have to get some local legends people together, see what we can get. There's the Ifriti. Look at that. Look at that fire blade. That's a great fun painting, that. Fantastic. The ghost pirate. This is probably one of my favourite pictures. It is a ghost pirate. I love the fact there's a little boat sticking out the water. You've got the water there. And you got barnacles on it, look. Look at that. And yeah, that could be a giant octopus or a kraken or something. Oh, wow. Look at that. That is a great detail. We've got an upside down one here. Who's this? That is looking, what is that? It's part of the one with all the arms sticking out. It's going to be the boss. And you can see how thick this is, look. They haven't skimped on the plastic. What we got? Oh, this is the berserker. That's not. Look. That weird 3D effect pointing out the screen. Giant blades. So this. Oh, it's got. Look. He's stepping on someone. Superb. So that's the berserker. We have the owlbear. That's actually quite nice. I do like that. The sleek black on here, look. That's really nice. I like the feathers. Again, look at the detail. Get some of our pro painters onto this. And then we have what reminds me of Man-Bat. If you're a fan of DC Comics and Batman, do you remember Man-Bat? That's what this is. And that's what I'm assuming that is what those little bats are going to be connected to. So you're going to get like some distractions, some smaller creatures, and then you're going to get the boss. Brilliant. Love it. That's all of them. And we've got some cards. What are these cards for? So this is going to be for Bard Song. Let's have a quick look, because I am, as I said, big fan of Bard Song. Richard or anyone from the team, if you know if anything is, is there more stuff about some coming out? Do we get a little bit more? Another expansion maybe? Add-on? I guess it depends on how well this works out. Because it means you could do some more fairly easy. Right, so this is Bard Song. Are these all going to be... No, they're different. They're different. Brilliant. So we've got some monster encounters. And this depends on what you do and how you hit them and everything else. Oof. Oh. Depends what level... Really nice. The giant bat. Swarm. Firebrand. Oh, really good. I miss playing Bard Song. I know we got a lot of board games. We do a lot of games. Not just on the channel, but also as part of the club. We play a lot of games. And 2024, we're actually going out a bit further. We're going to try different areas. We're going to be doing stuff at UK Games Expo, that we know about. You probably know about that as well. But also, we're going to try and be doing some stuff in Cornwall. Oh, look there, look at that. Oh, it's a Will-O-Wisp. That's brilliant. Love it. Right. So, that is those. Now, at the end of that, that's it. I'm going to pack those up. I'm going to start playing a game. So I'll see you soon. Until next time, remember to like and subscribe. And I'll put some pictures up on Instagram.com/BannerBadgers. Go check it out. See you soon. Bye.